and welcome back to Scale Me Down. Welcome back to the workshop and to another episode of this radio-controlled Pilatus PC6 turboporter with variable pitch propeller. Please like and subscribe to support the channel. If you recall, last time we'd had a bit of a setback when one of these 3D printed propeller blades failed right here at the root at the tang. So in this episode, we're going to revisit how we produce the propeller blades for this model, and we're also going to produce a test stand to try out some different ideas. Let's get started. To make our test rig, we're going to start by fastening these scrap wood battens down firmly to this heavy concrete base. I use a bit of tape on a Mason Master drill bit to set the correct depth for the holes. When the tape brushes the dust away, the roll plug should fit perfectly. Back to the workshop, where we'll use these corner brackets from the local hardware store to support the verticals. Drilling pilot holes and using a bit of soap on the screws makes the job really easy. There we go, that should be strong enough. There we have our brackets, and here I've drilled this piece of plywood to represent the firewall of the aircraft, and I've fitted it with these captive nuts, so now we should be able to bolt all of this stuff back together again to make our test stand. This platform is to support the pitch change servo and speed controller and other sundries. Hopefully, that should be strong enough. Meanwhile, back to the design of the propeller blades. And if you look at one of the surviving blades from last time, you'll notice that the mounting hole has become elongated and elliptical. So I've redesigned the propeller blades, moving the mounting hole further outboard. That puts a bit more meat on the tang back here. And I've also decided to sleeve this hole with some 3mm inside diameter brass tubing from a local hardware store. I also need to remove this raft and support material from the 3D printing. Changing the digital design didn't take too long. This tool can be used to set a face parallel with a print bed. Here, that's the top surface of the blade tang. Changing the orientation that we print the blades can have a dramatic effect on their strength, and that's because the layers act like the grain in a piece of wood. I'm
roughening the outside of the brass tube so that it bonds well and cutting it down to length.
To grind the end of the tubes nice and flat and perpendicular, I've drilled three holes in this piece of scrap plywood and pushed the tubes through, and now we'll just grind them flush on the bench sander.
This JB Weld epoxy should make a strong bond between the sleeve and the blades. Here we have a finished blade.
Back to the pitch change mechanism then. And here I've reassembled our motor with all the mechanics onto this mounting board, along with a newly designed version of our bearing holder. I also have two modifications for the other side of the firewall. And that's because the servo that moves the inner piston was describing an arc, and this inner rod must be kept parallel to the motor shaft. First, my friend Mark machined this piece of brass for me on his lathe, and it's a nice sliding fit on the inner rod. It's secured at both ends with bearings, which in turn are held with these clamshell bearing holders like this. Next, I redesigned the pitch change arm to incorporate this hinge. This allows the arm to grow longer or shorter as the pitch change servo horn describes an arc, whilst keeping the motion completely linear. The pitch change mechanism appears to be working well. You'll notice though that this arm here is a little bit wibbly wobbly. So we're going to redesign it to include two bearings rather than one, as we have a little bit of slop and lost motion.
So it's back to SketchUp to redesign the upper part of this arm. Some of our viewers have commented saying that Fusion 360 is a much better design program, and I agree, I really must learn how to use it, as this program is full of little bugs, as you can see. This finished arm has a bearing pressed into both sides. That seems to work a bit better with less slop.
Time for the test. And what we're looking to find with this test rig is to see if it all holds together. Is the propeller diameter big enough? Do we have enough pitch range? And does the governor work? And in order to answer some of these questions, I've added some instrumentation to our test rig, including a tachometer, which will measure the RPM, which hopefully won't change much as we adjust the propeller pitch, and also a clamp style ammeter to measure the current via the induced magnetic field. And I've mounted the rig outside in a direction that if we have a failure, that it won't cause any injury or damage to anything else. So here goes.
Oh no, not again.
So what went wrong then? Well, I was struggling to control the RPM, and in fairness, I've not used this brand of speed controller from 4MAX before. I only chose it to save some cost, as usually I use Castle speed controllers for my helicopter applications. And in general, I understand how their governor system works better. What happened this time, the blade grip failed. And if you recall, the blade grips are taken from a T-Rex 450 helicopter, although the failure happened at around 8,500 RPM. I was expecting that if the governor was working, that it should stabilise at around 5,500 RPM. So what I need to do next then is change the blade grips and also the speed controller. But clearly there's going to be a further delay. I'm not ready to give up on this project yet though. There's plenty of things to try. And there were some positives to take from this experience. First is that the blades themselves actually held up. Obviously the one that hit the ground is broken, but the blades themselves held up with the sleeved mount. Second, the pitch change mechanism now is nice and smooth and parallel, and that held up nicely too. So stay tuned to more updates on this Pilatus PC6 turboporter with variable pitch propeller, and thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.